Shalom. Actually, this is, oh well, who cares? Excuse I, the reason I guess we kind of started off a little bit weird is because we have the camera set to HD. We try to keep it off, we try to keep it on the most minimum, I guess like the least quality. That way we could record like very long videos and not have to worry about large files, and it makes a big difference. So, you know, and that's because we bring forth like these teachings, we bring them forth in Spanish, and it's too much, it's just too much time. And hour long presentations on HD can be excessively or extremely large files, and so, but anyways, nonetheless, this is Ras Alonso Tafare of the Lion of Judah Society, and we're reporting from this channel on YouTube, Rastafari Fellowship. Today's date is Thursday, October 12th, 2017. It's 5:03 p.m. Now, we have this presentation, the which we did in Spanish on our channels, LOJ Society Issachar, LOJ Society Español, and it took place on a Shabbat, Saturday morning, and it happened September 23rd, 2017. Now, it turns out that morning we were looking for a picture so that we could present on. And we call these presentations in which we utilize pictures that contain like text or information or you know, like a description or a detail. We call those informes, and particularly all those like pictures that come out in magazines and newspapers and informative stuff. So informatives, we would say, would be the translation in English. We do that because a lot of that information is available in English, not in Spanish, and so we improvise on the spot, you know, translation, and therefore, you know, it works out because it's an image, it's got information, and we can translate it very simply on the spot, and it makes it beneficial for all of us in many different ways. And so we were looking for a certain image that we were working on, and that same morning we came across an other image that we have seen before. We've seen it before plenty of times, except we noticed that it was a little bit different, and we're talking about this image right here. We noticed that it was a little bit different, and that the quality, the resolution looked a lot better. And so we decided to click on it, and it turns out that the quality was a lot better. Now, the article, the newspaper clipping, isn't necessarily complete. As a matter of fact, it doesn't even look as if it's a real newspaper. It's actually a printed copy of what may have been a saved, like archived newspaper. Paper, I don't know, like some kind of like it was printed. Basically, it's not it. The picture don't seem to come from an actual newspaper, but a copy of a archived, you know, whatever you call that. I don't know how to describe it. So, anyways, we'd seen this before, but it was never eligible, and we always did kind of like wonder what it said, and we would have liked to have had the opportunity to read it. So when we came across it and realized it was at a better resolution, better quality, we saved it and did the improvised translation in Spanish. And it's a very interesting, important documentation. And it, you know, not to make a big deal of what we are preparing to announce, but it turns out that as we were reading the information on the newspaper, or copy of this newspaper, we start off, excuse me, let me go forward in saying that we start off all of our presentations like stating the date, the time, and the day, and all that kind of stuff. It works out because then stuff are more easily documented, and you know, it's easier to keep in order. So anyways, And certain things have happened throughout the years that have led us to conclude that it actually serves a benefit or a good purpose, in the sense that sometimes for reference sake, for whatever reasons, different kind of things have happened in which we realized that having had declared or stated the time, date, and day and all that kind of stuff, it works out. It becomes very convenient. So anyways, as we had already like introduced ourselves, and then we were working on translating on the spot the information, and we read the date that this article was released or made public, and we were like, kind of like, and you can refer to the video, that we're kind of like, wait a minute, it sounds kind of familiar, what's today? And so we ask ourselves while we're recording, and it's like, wait a minute, it's like, what's today? And then we check the date, and it turned out that it was Saturday, September 23rd, 2017, and it was that same morning that we had found this picture. And it turns out that this article was actually released or made public that same date. So, not that it's like this super important detail, but some of us have expressed our interest in that. So we go to details and see if we're able to see four of four items, and that refers to some pictures I got downloaded. It says the Emperor Haile Selassie, I first. 1944, September, that is the ninth month, the 23rd day. That's the title of this image. The Chicago Defender. And time that we uploaded it was September 23rd, 2017, 9:24 a.m. So, not to make a big deal about it, but just for the record. So now, going forward to the actual document, we're gonna, try to read it, and not everything is eligible, and it's not complete. So we're just gonna read what is here, and we're gonna, try our very hardest not to make any comments on anything, to keep this short. We are recording in HD. So it says, Haile Selassie, world's most respected prophet, Defender, Washington Bureau, the Chicago Defender, National Edition, 1921 to 1967, September 23rd, 1944. It says ProQuest Historical Newspapers, Chicago Defender, 1910, 1975, page 18. So it goes on to say, the title is Haile Selassie, world's most respected prophet. Now, it says Defender, Washington Bureau, Washington. There will only be a lasting peace in the United States of America if the United States of America takes a leading hand in the moral leadership of the world. Quote, unquote. This prophecy was addressed to a group of delegates to the League of Nations conference in an informal gathering at Geneva's Hotel des Tercaes. It's not really all that eligible, but and I'm sure I'm not pronouncing it correctly, but something like Desbergues, maybe A, maybe E, maybe U, maybe S, I don't know. Des Burques, Burgares, Berques, I don't know. Then it says, it was uttered in 1930 by a diminutive man, possessant of a delicacy rarely found in even the ruling class of which he was a member. The man was Haile Selassie, who bore the title King of Kings, the Lion of Judah, Defender of the Christian Faith, Emperor of the Ancient Kingdom of Ethiopia, the Chosen of God. Goes on to say, such a prophecy could be logically expected to be met by at least mental doubts. Such a prophecy could be logically expected to be met by at least mental doubts. However, the minds of those assembled in the Geneva Hotel suite seemed to give as little argument to the little ruler's statement as their vocal cords. For the prophetic, and then I really can't read what that says, the prophetic something, I don't know. It's not even, the letters don't even appear in full. Then it continues, so it says, for the prophetic blank of the spokesman who had seen his 10 million, if I'm not mistaken, 10 million subjects enslaved by Benito Mussolini's fascist raiders a year before. Now, I will say that, okay, so this prophecy that is recorded is documented to have taken place in 1930. Now, this enslavement of his 10 million subjects enslaved by Benito Mussolini's fascist raiders a year before, when it says a year before, it means, this argument of little statement as their vocal cords. For the prophetic blank of the spokesman who had seen his 10 million subjects enslaved by Benito Mussolini's fascist raiders a year before had become almost legendary. Well, it's probably a reference to 1936, Geneva, Switzerland, the address to the League of Nations. So it says, as a matter of fact, it was his prophecy in connection with this cowardly attack. Yes, it's in reference to the attack, that the invasion of fascist Italy in 1936. So it continues, as a matter of fact, it was his prophecy in connection with this cowardly attack that first attracted attention to his uncanny ability to see into the future. And then I don't know what it reads here. That first opening word is blank. The year 1923, Haile Selassie sitting pensively, pensively upon his throne in the palace at Addis Ababa, capital of Ethiopia, predicted, we shall be attacked by Mussolini in 2 years. Wait a minute, I read something wrong. It says 19, says here, 1933, I believe it reads. Anyways, excuse I for that. 1933. And that's important because obviously the writer wouldn't be saying that this prophetic statement was accurate if it would have been off. So even though it's hard to read, it says attention to what, well, actually it says, as a matter of fact, well, excuse, I knew it was going to be difficult to read, even in Spanish it was hard. As a matter of fact, it was his prophecy in connection with this cowardly attack that first attracted attention to his uncanny ability to see into the future. In the year, maybe it says in the year, or blank, the year 1933, Haile Selassie sitting pensively upon his throne in the palace at Addis Ababa, capital of Ethiopia, predicted, we shall be attacked by Mussolini in 2 years. And then it says, prediction fulfilled. History can testify that the prediction was more than fulfilled, for on October 3, 1935, now this is evidence to the fact that this other date is 1933, because basically it says October 3rd, 1935, so that's 2 years, the Italian army launched the vicious, and then I can't read anything else at all. So now we're going to go forward to this side, and it says, so the document is not complete. And it continues on reading, or in misery. And the cure, or the curse of the bombed Ethiopian, and the curse of the bombed Ethiopian people will be on his soul for all eternity. It is rumored that the former Italian dictator, now in Germany, is the victim of an incurable malady, something like that. His son-in-law, Count Kian or Klan, I don't know, was executed for conspiracy, maybe, by order of Mussolini. As an exile in England, the little king prophesied in I really can't tell what the date is. Prophesied in 1937, it appears. Or, yeah, there will be something like that. 1937, it appears. There will be a Second World War as a result of what happened to Ethiopia. For that violation of an independent country will only encourage aggression. A terrible conflict lies ahead. On the heels of this statement, he uttered, as in, I don't know, of fall first. Fall for, oh, wait. It says, as in the something of Ethiopia, the weaker nations will fall first, but the powers of evil will be overthrown. And the weakest of these, Mussolini's Italy, will be the first to fall, followed by Hitler. Continue saying, predicts defeat. Later, he told a correspondent, I think that's what it says, it will take 3 years to defeat, I think, or something like that, the rapacious fascist and his crew, or something like that. Benito Mussolini, man, I don't know. Benito Mussolini, let's see, independent country overthrown. Benito Mussolini, his dictator purge, just 3 years. I don't know what it says there. So Benito Mussolini, blank, blank, dictator purge, just 3 years following his vulture-like attitude towards fallen France. 1 year after the fall of Italy, the Allies will be victorious in Europe. The victory will take place around Arunistice, I don't know what it says, Armistice, Arunistice, I don't know, day, whatever that means. Sometime near November 11th, 1944. These words also, okay, let's see. These words were also spoken by the prophet of Addis Ababa during his period of exile in the United Kingdom in view on the period. Let me read that again. These words also were spoken by the prophet of Addis Ababa during his period of exile in the United Kingdom. In view of recent developments in Europe, it seems more than likely that Haile Selassie has scared again as a dependable reader of the future. And then it goes on to say, and so of nine world, and I don't know what else is there. So basically, let's see. Yeah, that's pretty much it. Gracias, Shalom.